Well, as I promised, I've decided to start doing some more interviews. I had a chance this weekend to sit down with a couple that's here from Canada. They've been living here for about a little over a year, about half the time that I've been here. I had a great chat with them yesterday, and as soon as I come back, we'll get started with the interview.
Hey!
Roger!
Oh, rock a cheek.
Roger!
Hello there.
So as I said, I met with the Jordans yesterday, J-O-R-D-A-N-S. Very nice couple. This is Sue and Phil Jordan. I met them through some mutual friends of ours. They actually live on the Monte Cristi golf course, of which I'm doing a video about as well this week. It's gonna take a lot more editing to get it done than this one. But anyway, I sat down with them in one of the conference rooms at the Monte Cristi golf resort yesterday, and we had a little chat, and I'm going to share it with you here in just a couple minutes. I want to warn you ahead of time, we sat in a room that had an air conditioner on the wall, and it had a little high-pitched sound to it, and I was able to get most of it out in post-editing. I think I got most of it, but anyway, if you hear it, know that I just warned you about it, okay? So anyway, here are the Jordans, and I hope you get something out of this. And they're just telling their story like it is, okay? Here they are.
So I'm sitting here with Sue and Phil Jordan. Where are you guys from? You're Canada, right?
That's correct, yeah.
Did you know that I've never met a Canadian I didn't like?
We're from the Calgary, Alberta area.
Calgary, Alberta.
And we Canadians, we try to behave ourselves.
Yeah,
and
that's
I'm sorry.
What I hear.
Yes. Yes, we say I'm sorry a lot. So,
what made you decide to come to Ecuador?
That's an excellent question. In 2015, I had an opportunity to travel with a friend, and she was looking at the opportunity to retire and said, just come along for the ride. So I did. And when I got down here, I fell in love with the country. So it was on my bucket list to one day live here. Mm-hmm. I saw the potential. And then wasn't able to do that until last year when Phil and I came back for another exploratory trip. And he said, I see what you see. And that's when we decided that we wanted to be here full time.
So how many exploratory trips? You did two?
Yes. I had two and Phil had one.
Yes. Okay. You came?
2015, okay. The first time.
When did you move here?
In June 22.
June 22.
Yep. So we've been here just a little over 8 months.
Yeah.
So.
Wow. Yeah. I've been here longer than you.
Yes.
About twice as long. A little over twice. Yeah. And so I talk to people all the time about, you know, living here and going through the honeymoon and dealing with culture shock and all that kind of stuff. What was that like for you? Did you have any culture shock?
I think anyone who moves here, there's got to be sort of a bit of a personality type where, you know, you can look at things and even though there's some difficult things, you can see the good.
Yeah.
So yes, there was some challenges. Language is a barrier. There's no doubt about that. However, technology allows us to be able to, you know, translate loosely, you know, Spanish to English and vice versa. You know, there is some poverty that's hard to see.
Yeah.
But for myself, if you've got an open mind and are willing to kind of see the potential, there is so much potential here.
Sure.
You definitely have to be adventurous to give up everything in your home country and travel to Latin America. It's not for everybody. We realize that, but we've always been very adventurous.
So from, let's go back home. Before you made the decision to come here, how did you discover Ecuador? What made you think of Ecuador?
It was a fluke. It was my friend, Vicky France, who said, you know, let's go on a trip. She'd been to Ecuador once, and I'm like, Ecuador? Where is Ecuador? So, you know, you had loosely, I mean, I knew it was kind of somewhere around the equator. it was never on my horizon. It's not a necessarily a vacation destination for a lot of people. It's not the easiest place to get to. There's, you know, some difficult flights that you have to hop on to travel here, although that's going to be changing, I think, in the future.
Yeah.
But yeah, so it was an opportunity to see this country. And we traveled with a company called Ecuador Expat Journeys,
yeah,
that takes you through the entire country. So we started in Quito. We went all the way, you know, around down to Salinas. We saw Manta, Guayaquil, Loja, and then down to Vilcabamba. So we got to see the entire country and the potential of living here. And that's how it all started.
A lot of people don't realize how small the country of Ecuador is. I tell people it's about the size of Arizona. And I've heard people coming here and taking these tours and seeing all these cities, and it's really not that hard to do.
Yes.
Because it's not like traveling all over Canada or
yes,
all over the United States, you know.
On this tour, we'd only travel a couple hours a day.
Did you?
And go from one city to the next. And, you know, we'd leave at 9 o'clock in the morning, and by noon we'd be at the next place and exploring it.
So when you did this tour, did you pre-book all your places to spend the night? Or how was that happening?
So
we're taking care of.
Yeah, this tour is comprehensive.
They do
so
everything.
So you basically sign up for the tour. You have to do your own airfare to get here and return back
sure,
home. But they take care of literally everything. So they book all the hotels. And they're not, they're sort of your mom and pop hotels that you stay at. So it's a real family kind
mm-hmm,
of feel. And you get really immersed into the culture. So
yeah,
that was, I think for us, there was no shell shocks because we'd seen so much of many of the
yeah,
locations.
So transportation, all your accommodations, and most of your meals are taken care of by the company.
What's the name of the company again?
Ecuador Expat Journeys.
Ecuador.
Yeah.
I'm going to put a link to it in the description.
Yeah, yeah. Jonathan Hall is the founder of the company, mm-hmm, and I can't think of Susie's last name, but so he is a partner as well.
So how many people were with you on this trip?
When we did our trip, it unfortunately was COVID was still on or still prevalent, and we only had 13 on our trip in 2021.
Nice.
Yes. Susan was down in 15.
There was 26 of us.
26.
Yeah. And that was still phenomenal. So we were on a bus. Ray, the bus driver, was an incredible driver,
yeah,
one of the safest, you know, companies that there is out there. They really take care of, you know, every element. You know, they're
mm-hmm,
concerned about showing you Ecuador sort of at that grassroots level and not selling you property in Ecuador, but the potential of living here. What could you possibly do if you really, really wanted to relocate?
So I'll ask you this only one time, okay? After you got here and you got settled in, well, when you came here, where did you actually start? Were you in Manta or here?
We landed in Olong.
Okay.
Which is, I don't know, about 2 hour drive down
mm-hmm,
the coast here. And it's a smallish town, beach town. And we thought that, we toured that, and we thought that that would be the place where we liked. But it rained a lot.
Yeah.
We only had accommodations for 30 days.
Okay.
And we were not having trouble, but we couldn't really find accommodations in our budget.
Okay.
And some friends of ours came down from Manta and spent the weekend with us in Alone and talked us into coming back to Manta with them. And we never went back.
And where do you live now?
We live here at the Monte Cristi Golf Resort.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm doing a separate video on that golf course. And this will be a separate one here. And you guys are very active and heavily involved in that golf course. Yeah, so it's fair to say you like golf. Both of you play golf?
Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, we golf 4 or 5 times a week. Yeah.
And don't you ever get tired of that?
Only when you're not having
hit
the greatest
a ball,
day.
Run after it. Hit a ball, run after it.
You know, that's a great question. Yes, I suppose we could be tired of it, but what we do is we golf early in the morning and then we generally have a swim. We're right now renting at Zafiro Condominiums, which is a great, you know, there's all kinds of amenities there, very comfortable. And then we've got the rest of the afternoon. Oftentimes we do go into Manta,
yeah,
Manta and, you know, go out for dinner, meet with friends. There's always something to do. There's such an amazing group of people that we've connected with. So it's never really a dull day.
I ran into you in my second office the other day.
Yes, you did, yes.
Dalton Promoso.
Yes.
So other than golf, what else do you do? What do you do in the afternoon? What other activities can you do up here?
Well,
great question.
Yeah, so here at the golf course, they have paddleball courts, they have volleyball, they have tennis, there's a soccer pitch, plus there's four, a soccer pitch, a soccer field.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Or a football field, I guess, is what it would be here. Soccer in Canada, football in Ecuador.
Yeah.
They also have four pools and a whole recreation center where there's a gym and cabanas where you can have a barbecue and, you know, they're full service.
Mm-hmm.
So that's really nice. Again, we stay pretty busy.
Yeah. How's your health?
Our health is excellent. I think some of the one of the reasons for me to look at Ecuador was the simple fact that the food is clean food. You're eating, I mean, vine ripened everything.
Yeah.
So for us, it's the healthy living.
Mm-hmm.
We do a lot of walking. When we golf in the morning, we walk down here from Zafiro, and that's a good 20-minute walk for us.
Okay.
So our health has improved, I would say, tenfold since we've moved here. Yeah.
Where do you go grocery shopping?
So just,
I'm sorry to interrupt, but just so everybody knows, Monte Cristi is about a 10-minute taxi ride from Monte.
Yes.
So
yes.
It's more inland. So that's why, I know in Monte we have all the major grocery stores, but I'm thinking, do you go to Monte for your grocery shopping, or do you?
Sometimes we do, but only when it's convenient. So we don't take trips to Monta to grocery shop, but if we're in Monta and at the mall, we'll stop by Mega Maxi.
Yeah.
There are a few things there that we like to get that we can't find anywhere else.
Mm-hmm.
But there's a couple of great grocery stores here in Monte Cristi. There's the Mia Commissariato that's at the roundabout here in the main part of town. And then there's a Tia that's downtown, but we tend to, well, we buy stuff there, but we tend to go to the local frutas and the bakeries and the meat shops, and we buy local. And we find that, especially when it comes to the produce, buying from the local fruta, it's cheaper.
Yeah.
It's, it's fresher and it's much tastier, and the people they love us, right? And then we're not the only gringos in town, but we do stand out in the crowd because there's a lot less gringos here in Monte Cristi than there is in Manta, and they see us coming, they like us a lot.
That's
you pointed something out, Don, that it's very convenient to get from Monta to Monte Cristi, about 10-15 minute taxi ride.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's not, Monte Cristi isn't quite the tourist destination yet that Monta is, but there is some phenomenal stores out there. Like there's some wicker stores, there's the Modesta Hat Factory, there's a museum there. So there's some really quaint little stores and shops. Great restaurants. So. You go for almuerzo for $2.50, $3 for a really nice almuerzo. So
I was going to mention Monte Cristi or Modesto hats. I tell everybody when they come to Monte, plan a day to go get Juan Zambrano and come up here and let him take you around. And you have to go to Modesto hats and see how they make the Panama hats.
Yeah.
We traveled with one exactly to do that one day and had a great day out here.
Yeah.
So.
Ended up with a couple of really nice Panama hats.
Yeah, yes. I did too, that I never wear. But I don't regret buying. Do you ever go back home?
We haven't yet.
This is home now, but your other home.
So going back to Calgary, we'll be heading there in August. My youngest son is getting married. And then we're hoping that family and friends will come and visit because there's other plans on the horizon for Phil and I to make the golf course more permanent home.
Sure. I have a lot of Canadian friends that I knew when I lived in Mesa, Arizona. They came down for the winter. Mm-hmm. Now it's getting so expensive there. I tell people all the time, Canadian friends of mine say, come to Montreal, you know, for 6 months or 4 months or whatever, you know, during the heat of the winter.
Even with the exchange, it's very, very economical to live here.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, so I'll ask you one last question. I'm getting ready to ask this to everybody. Think of one word in your mind. What is one word you can think of that represents your experience with living in Ecuador?
For me, it's kindness.
Kindness?
Kindness. Yeah. The people are unbelievably kind.
Yeah. How about you, Ben?
Tranquilo.
Tranquilo, yeah.
Yeah. So this is just the greatest atmosphere here. I always say the same thing. It's like Groundhog Day. The weather never changes.
Yeah.
There's no real weather here. It never, the wind never blows. There's never any thunderstorms. We don't have any chance of any hurricanes or anything like that.
Yeah, no tornadoes.
You don't get that everywhere. I mean, some people might look to some of the Caribbean countries to immigrate to, and that's another thing too. The immigration process is friendly, and they want you here, and you can't say that to every country. They'll only keep you for 6 months.
Yeah. So you have your visas now, right?
Yes, we do.
Okay.
Yeah. I was going to say one of the other slight differences between Monta and Monte Cristi, at least on the golf course, is it is so quiet.
Yes.
So quiet.
I was going to bring that up.
Yes, it's, and I mean, there is at the Zafiro, there's families that come in for the weekends and they enjoy their time. And New Year's was a bit of an eye opener. So we heard a few firecrackers going off, and they partied till, well, at 7:30 in the morning.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So
my one word is noise. You know?
Yeah.
So, but even at that, I'm starting to get used to it. I'm noticing that I'm able to tune out a lot of the stuff that used to really bother me.
And it actually becomes white noise?
It does. Yes. It actually becomes like the dogs barking or the alarms going off.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I hear them, but I don't hear them. You know?
Well, this morning there was a single mosquito flying around in our bed.
Oh my God.
It was bothering the both of us. So that's how quiet it is.
Was that enough to make you want to go home?
No, but it was just funny because I woke up to buzzing in my ear, and I just thought, oh, yeah. No roosters.
No, but a mosquito of all things, yeah.
People talk about mosquitoes all the time. I've seen very few.
It's not a problem.
I don't think it is either. I think
it might. They might increase a little bit with apparently the rainy season is coming in, but. And that could shift some things.
There are mosquitoes, but they're not a problem.
Right. I know you covered it on your tour, but have you been to Cuenca for any length of time?
Yes.
Like a week or so? Or
we were there for 3 days.
Oh, yeah?
What did you think of that? We were there recently, too.
Yeah. What did you think of Cuenca?
Cuenca is beautiful. It's absolutely lovely. It's a very historic, you know, there's a lot of history there and steeped in the Spanish kind of tradition. It's gorgeous, the, you know, architecture and stuff like that. We did find for the first time a little bit of altitude.
Yes.
It bothered us to some degree, but we were okay.
Yeah. Okay, let's go eat some lunch. What do you think?
Are you hungry? Yes.
Yeah, I'm getting hungry. Yeah.
Okay, all right.
It's been a great pleasure meeting you, and you know, people keep telling me, we need more interviews, we need interviews, because they want to get some perspective from other people than just me.
Well, so you really appreciate you taking the time today and coming to us and seeing a little bit of what we experience in a day.
Yeah, now we're going to go see the golf course and
have some amazing ceviche, some of the best. The menu here is incredible. So,
and there are two restaurants on site here, and both of them are phenomenal.
Yeah.
The menus are quite different, but I haven't eaten anything yet that I didn't like.
That's good. That's what I feel about a lot of the places that I eat in Montu.
Mm-hmm.
The food here is just phenomenal.
It really, really is. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you, Don.
See you later.
Alrighty.
So that's it. Great people. We had lunch after we met for the interview yesterday. We had lunch at the restaurant there at the Monte Cristo Golf Resort. Great lunch. Best potato soup I think I've ever had. I can't remember the last time I had such a good lunch as we had yesterday. But that's the Jordans. Thanks for watching, folks. If you like this channel, please subscribe. If you like this video, smash that thumbs up button, okay? And if you didn't like it, then bite me, okay? Have a great day. I'll see you on the next one, okay? Ciao, ciao.
Tell you, babe, I've been really having something in my ear bad.
What is it?
I don't know. I'm using Q-tips. So. Oh.
Oh, God. That's horrible.